We start fasting when we see the moon, when we sight the moon, when we see the crescent of the moon. It's not a matter that we should not follow the calculations or we should not use the high technology. No. Because of the simplicity, this is one of the main factors, one of the main ingredients of this deen, it's simplicity. Very simple. And it's very easy to implement and follow its teachings. The Arabs, as you know, they were illiterate nation. They were illiterate, they were nomadic tribes. So they don't know how to read or write. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, out of his wisdom, he tied all the ibadat with signs that he made, which is what the moon is one of them. The moon is one of them. Very precise, no error at all. Not even zero. Not even 0.1 error at all. So the sun will the five prayers are attributed to the appearance of the sun, etc. So here, we have to follow the moon. If we see the moon, we fast. If we don't see it, we don't fast. And the same thing for the Eid. And the same thing for the Eid. And even if only one Muslim, imagine, even if one Muslim saw the moon and he reports it to the Qadi, then the whole Ummah, the whole nation should fast. Unfortunately, we see now this disunity and division among the Muslims, that this country is fasting, the other one are not fasting. This is really very sad. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to unite our hearts upon the truth, inshallah. And maybe the whole Ummah one day will fast together, inshallah. And also, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in another hadith, he said, we are an illiterate nation. We neither write nor accounts. The month is like this and this. And he said, the month like this. That's 30 days, then 9 days. So it means in the month, because we in Islam, we are following the moon. So our calendar is lunar calendar, not solar calendar. So the month can be 30 days or 29 days. This is the month in Islam. The month will never be 31 days. And the month will never be 28 days. It's either 130 days or 29 days. That's what the Prophet ﷺ said. And when he said we are an illiterate nation, some Muslims might pose the question, you know, this hadith is applied to the past. When the Sahaba and the companions, they were illiterate. But now we are educated. So this hadith cannot be applied. Here there is a mistake, there is a misconception. What the Prophet ﷺ meant here, that the simplicity, that we are not complicated nation. There's no more complexity that we have to use the telescopes and we have to track the moon. What is the use of it? Just by the naked eye, wherever you are, the farmer who's in his farm will just go and see. If he sees it, that's all. He has to fast. If he didn't see, this is actually a credit for Islam, that it is so practical and so simple. So practical and so simple. And the final hadith I would like, inshallah, to mention is the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said regarding breaking the fast, we should immediately break the fast. Immediately break the fast. The moment we see this, if you are seeing the sun, and the moment the sun sets, break your fast. Don't wait for the Adhan even. But if you can't see the sun, then for the Adhan. And no need for you to wait until the Adhan finishes. Immediately break the fast. He said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the people will remain on the right path as long as they hasten their iftar and delay the suhoor. So the suhoor we delay and the iftar we hasten it. Immediately we break the fast. And we break it, as we're going to know, inshallah, in on date, etc. And so this is, inshallah, a brief introduction about the fasting, and I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to increase our knowledge in his deen and unite our hearts upon the deen and unite our heart upon the true deen, the deen that was revealed and the deen that preached and taught by Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his companions. And I think now we are heading towards the end. And inshallah, going inshallah now to give you for 10 minutes, I think, dedicated for question and time. And it's time, I think, now for questions and answers. Yes.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. We know that the month of Ramadan is a special occasion in the life of the Muslim. Would you kindly tell me about the exemplary way to make the best use of my time in during the day of Ramadan to get the desired spiritual benefits from Ramadan?
Jazakallah. This is a good question, because unfortunately that many Muslims, they forgot the real aim and objective of fasting, which is the taqwa. So what they fast, they fast only, they abstain from eating, drinking, etc. But at the same time, how do they spend their day? They spend their day watching things which are displeasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I request you, brothers and sisters, at least for the holy month, during the holy month of Ramadan, that we have to try not to watch this little window at home. You know it. What is it? The television. Try to, at least during the holy month of Ramadan, so that you will increase your iman. How you want your iman to increase while you are watching things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not reward you for it, which is displeasing Allah. Your eye should practice the siyam, the fast. Your eye should abstain from watching haram things. Your ears should abstain from listening to the haram things. Your hands, your tongues. Not that you are watching these things and then you think Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept your fast. Ramadan is the month of Quran. We read in history of our pious predecessors, what we call them, the Salaf al-Salih, that they leave the study circles. When the month of Ramadan comes, they would leave the study circles and they would dedicate themselves to the holy month of Ramadan, praying, worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, reading the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And regarding reading the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, some Muslims, the way they treat the book of Allah, first of all, many Muslims, they have deserted the book of Allah throughout the year, and they only open it on Ramadan. And this is what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam complained to his Rabb, to Allah, وَقَالَ الرَّسُولُ يَا رَبِّ إِنَّ قَوْمِ اتَّخَذُوا هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ مَهْجُورًا. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, brothers and sisters, is complaining against us to his Lord. Oh my Lord, my followers, they have deserted and neglected this book. So you find them only, they open the book of Ramadan during Ramadan, the book of Allah, the Quran during Ramadan. After Ramadan, they put it on the shelf. Even we got used that we should not listen to the Quran except at a certain time. The Quran became an evil omen in our life. For instance, if I hear the Quran at a time I'm not supposed to hear it, then I will conclude and I would say, who died? Right? I conclude who died, that because we are not used. So it is high time now. This is the holy book, the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is the Quran, that we will change our life. And only by turning back and going to the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the ummah, the Muslim ummah, the Muslim nation, they would gain their glory and regain the lost glory and their power and strength. Without going back to the book of Allah, imagine by just reading Alif Lam Mim, La Qul Alif Lam Mim Harf, Walakin Alif Harf, Wala Mun Harf, Wamim Harf. Just Alif Lam Mim, you got 30 hasana. 30 hasana. By listening to the book of Allah. Also, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whoever believes in Allah and the last day should read in the book of Allah. Should read. Open. And now there is no excuse. There is no excuse for any Muslim, even those who are illiterate. Even those who are illiterate who cannot read and write, they can listen. They can put the tape, lay the tape, and they can listen to the Quran. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to enlighten us and to open our hearts and to guide us to the straight path. Amen. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.